Hello and welcome to Docplexus News. The Union Cabinet has approved the Assisted Reproductive Technology Regulation Bill, which proposes the establishment of a registration authority for all clinics and also stringent punishment for sex determination and sale of human gametes. The bill seeks the protection of the reproductive rights of the commissioning couple and even the mother. Furthermore, the law involves the provision of a fine of Rs 10 lakhs for those who are involved in trafficking and sale of embryos in the first instance and imprisonment of up to 12 years in the second instance. The IRDAI has recently modified the regulations on pre-existing diseases and emergency hospital admissions for the benefit of policyholders. The change in the earlier rules includes chronic conditions such as hypertension, diabetes, and respiratory ailments, which will now get covered if deemed pre-existing. Also, claims are currently applicable in blacklisted hospitals in case of emergency accidents, heart attack, or stroke. Additionally, the changes in the rules have been extended to birth control, sterility, and infertility treatments. The US FDA has recently approved three drugs for non-prescription through the prescription to OTC switch. Through this process, many products sold over the counter use ingredients or dosage strengths which were earlier available only on prescription. The drugs included diclofenac sodium topical gel 1% for temporary relief of arthritis pain, olopatadine etzel ophthalmic solution 0.1 and 0.2% for temporary relief of itchy and red eyes due to pollen, ragweed, animal hair, etc. The Acting Deputy Director of the Office of Non-Prescription Drugs in the FDA added that this approval has the potential to improve public health. Doctors from a hospital in Faridabad have successfully performed first-of-its-kind jaw reconstruction surgery with a 3D-printed titanium jaw. An oral cancer survivor had lost the right half of his jawbone along with temporomandibular joint 7 years back. The patient also suffered an underlying congenital illness within the type of systemic lupus erythematosus, which impacted his immunity, and he had been on a liquid and a soft diet. With these complications, since the conventional methodology of using one's own lower leg bone was not admissible, the metallic additive manufacturing technique came to his rescue. After the surgery, he has been consuming regular meals. Recently, a group of surgeons from the Netherlands carried out a successful trial of robo-based supermicrosurgery for the treatment of breast cancer-related lymphedema. The technique allows the connection of the blocked lymph vessels with veins to re-establish the flow of lymphatic fluid and reduce the arm swelling in patients who have breast cancer. Surgeons activated the robo using foot pedals and operated forceps like joysticks to control high-precision surgical instruments. The technique can reduce hand tremors and motions during the surgery and provide high-precision results. The National Accreditation Board for Hospitals and Healthcare Providers has recently launched the fifth edition of the accreditation standards for hospitals. The NABH periodically revises its policies to improvise upon the regulations concerning certain aspects such as treatment, access to healthcare facilities, strategies for tackling emerging health issues, and promising innovations. Some notable highlights of the fifth edition include amendments like patient safety and quality, incorporation of WHO's 9 patient safety solutions, classifications of objective elements, and addition of new guidelines on documentation. Japan is now facing the mounting criticism for its weak quarantine arrangements when 79 new coronavirus positive cases were reported from the British grand-class cruise ship. With 621 positive cases, the cruise ship is the most significant cluster of infected people outside China. Claiming more than 2,000 lives in China, the coronavirus has spread panic worldwide, and in Japan, the newly diagnosed people will be taken off the cruise and then to the hospitals for further quarantine. A Pune-based hospital had recently performed left ventricular assist device implantation procedure on a young citizen from Yemen. The LVAD procedure involves implanting a mechanical device that runs on a mobile battery control unit and requires charging every 8 to 12 hours. The method provides an alternative to a heart transplant in patients suffering from end-stage heart failure, where other treatment options are not feasible. The doctors at the hospital added that the LVAD procedure could be considered as a beneficial therapy for long-term outcomes. A Canadian neurobiologist, David Hunter Hubble, is always remembered for his studies on the structure and function of the visual cortex. In 1981, he won the shared Nobel Prize with Torsten Wiesel in physiology and medicine category for the discovery concerning information processing in the optical system. The discovery helped in mapping the path of nerve impulses from the eye to various centers of the brain. This work opened the track for numerous technological advances. Docplexus appreciates his efforts in the field of medicine. Extend your gratitude by commenting below. These were the latest happenings in the medical field brought to you by Docplexus, the global online community of doctors. Stay tuned for more every Thursday at 6 p.m. Happy Docplexing!